Hello friends, so today we will discuss about the differentiation of several functions. Okay, so first is our differentiation of the algebra function. So let's see how algebra functions can be differentiated. So if the function is in the form x to the power n or y to the power n or z to the power n, then it can be differentiated as d by dx, means differentiation of x to the power n with respect to x. Okay, so differentiation of x to the power n with respect to x is n into x to the power n minus 1, okay, where n is any constant. Similarly, the differentiation of y to the power n with respect to y is n into y to the power n minus 1. And differentiation of z to the power n with respect to z is n into z to the power n minus 1, whereas n is any constant. Okay, where n is any constant. Now let us solve some example of algebra. So here we have to differentiate this function with respect to the given function. So we have to differentiate x cube, x to the power 1 by 2 and x to the power 3 by 4 with respect to x, and this function with respect to y, and this all function with respect to z. So first we will solve for x. So differentiation of x cube with respect to x is d by dx of x cube. See, it is in the form of x to the power n. So what is the formula? N into this, here n is 3, n into x to the power n minus 1, which is equal to 3x square. Okay, now differentiation of x to the power 1 by 2, here n is 1 by 2. Okay, so n into x to the power n minus 1, which is equal to 1 by 2 into x to the power minus 1 by 2. Now for the differentiation of x to the power 3 by 4, x to the power 3 by 4 is 3 by 4 into x to the power 3 by 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3 by 4 into x to the power minus 1 by 4. Okay, so in this method the differentiation, this function can be differentiated. Okay, now we will solve for the function of y. Now this function can be differentiated with respect to y. Okay, so differentiation of y to the power 5 with respect to y is equal to, here n is 5. Okay, so n into y to the power n minus 1, so here 5 into y to the power 4. And similarly for y to the power minus 1 by 3, so d by dy of y to the power minus 1 by 3 is, here n is minus 1 by 3, so minus 1 by 3 into y to the power n minus 1. Okay, so minus 1 by 3 into y to the power minus 4 by 3. And for y to the power 5 by 2, so d by dy of y to the power 5 by 2 is equal to 5 by 2 into y to the power 5 by 2 minus 1 is equal to 5 by 2 into y to the power 3 by 2. Okay, now for the function of z. So d by dz of z square, differentiation of z square with respect to z. So here n is 2, so 2 into z to the power 2 minus 1 is equal to 2 into z. And for z to the power 4 by 3, so d by dz of z to the power 4 by 3 is equal to 4 by 3 into z to the power 4 by 3 minus 1 is equal to 4 by 3 into z to the power 1 by 3. And last for z to the power minus 3 by 2. Here n is minus 3 by 2. So minus 3 by 2 into z to the power minus 3 by 2 minus 1 is equal to minus 3 by 2 into z to the power minus 5 by 2. Okay, so in this method, the algebra function of x to the power n or y to the power n or z to the power n can be differentiated. Okay, so now we will move forward to the differentiation of exponent and logarithmic functions. So what are the differentiation of exponent function? So the differentiation of exponent function doesn't change. Differentiation of e to the power x with respect to x is e to the power x, or differentiation of e to the power y with respect to y is equal to e to the power y, and differentiation of e to the power z with respect to z is e to the power z. So the differentiation of exponent function doesn't change. Now the differentiation of logarithmic function. So the differentiation of log x with respect to x is 1 by x. Similarly, differentiation of log y with respect to y is 1 by y, and for log z with respect to z is 1 by z. Now, the differentiation of inverse trigonometric function. Okay, as the differentiation of trigonometric function we have discussed in the previous video. So now the differentiation of inverse trigonometric function. So here, the differentiation of sine inverse x with respect to x is 1 by root under 1 minus x square. Okay, this is for x, and for y, here y square. For z, here z square. Okay, so for all the variable, it is satisfied. Only the variable will change. So the differentiation of sine inverse x with respect to x is 1 by root under 1 minus x square. For differentiation of cos inverse x with respect to x is minus 1 by root under 1 minus x square. Then for differentiation of tan inverse x with respect to x is 1 by 1 plus x square, and for cot inverse x with respect to x is minus 1 by 1 plus x square. For sec inverse x, for sec inverse x with respect to x is equal to 1 by mod x into root under x square minus 1. Okay, so the differentiation of sec inverse x with respect to x is equal to 1 by mod x into root under x square minus 1. And for differentiation of cosec inverse x with respect to x is minus 1 by mod x into root under x square minus 1. So all this differentiation you remember, this will help you in the chain rule. Okay, so in the next video I will discuss the chain rule. And one more differentiation is there. This is for differentiation of a to the power x. Okay, so the differentiation of a to the power x with respect to x is a to the power x into log a. And what is a here? A is any constant. Okay, so hope this video is helpful for you. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel. Thank you.